2014, scientists published a study and estimated the storage capacity of the internet to be 10 to the power 24 bytes, which means 24 zeros after digit 1. A byte is a data unit comprising 8 bits, which roughly equals to a single character in every word we speak. It is estimated that the internet has more storage capacity than there are grains of sand in all of the beaches and deserts combined. And according to a recent estimate, more than 4.5 billion people use internet, and every second, 24,000 HD movies worth of data is being uploaded on the internet. The internet isn't just a place of entertainment. It's a source of huge financial traffic too. Major corporates and MNCs rely on the internet. Even more than 60% of the small businesses are using internet to reach out to the customers. And not only that, but 70 to 80% of people research online before visiting a local business. Internet is the place for everything. But can it ever be switched off or destroyed? The answer, as always, is very interesting. But before we let you guys onto this destructive journey, we need you to hit that subscribe button and ring that bell so that you don't miss any of our future updates. Let's switch back to the hot topic. Can the internet ever be switched off or destroyed? Internet is not actually how you imagine it to be. Internet is thousands of miles of undersea fiber optic cables that help transfer data from continent to continent, branching out to connect millions of computers. So if you could destroy these cables, then the internet connection between two places would severely be hampered. Just like a grandma here who unknowingly cut the cable connecting internet between Georgia and Armenia. That's one way you might think you can destroy the internet. But wait, because there are more theories. What if you destroy all the devices that can access the internet, or destroy the internet giants like Google, Microsoft, Yahoo, etc.? Would that actually destroy the internet? No. The reality is that internet is not a single entity. It is heaps and heaps of data shared by people around the globe. If you're reading an article on the internet, then the article isn't a real physical entity, but a set of data which is not created by any internet official, but by someone from the internet community. The accessibility is the only thing that can be controlled, that too only by the government. It has a never-ending cycle of creators and audience, where creators become the audience and audience becomes the creator. And this loop between the creator and the audience makes this giant community of internet users. Since the existence of internet is virtual and it is not a single thing, it cannot be easily stopped or destroyed. Google, Bing, Yahoo are just few mediums to access the internet. So destroying fiber optic cables, internet devices, and internet giants like Google would never destroy the internet. The only thing that we would achieve by destroying these is the accessibility to internet. But there's a way, the only possible way to destroy internet. And it would be to destroy all the web servers. No matter what you do on the internet, be it Google or Instagram, all of them are websites. And websites are stored on proper web servers operated by web hosting companies. Websites like Google, Facebook, and other internet giants have their own web servers. Perks of being rich. These servers act like the data vaults of internet, and if you destroy these vaults, the data will cease to exist. And when that happens, internet will be a distant memory. But for that, you will have to destroy every single web server on our Mother Earth. And that is a very tedious task. But we think the internet is pretty dope and we should let it be as it is. And you should click that like button if you love the video and subscribe to our channel for much more.